Hello everyone, I welcome you all for this course on Kinematics of Machines presented by PTU eSikshana program. In this module 3, we are discussing on velocity and acceleration analysis of mechanisms using analytical approach. Coming for what we have discussed till this point, that we have studied Raven's approach, that is complex algebra method, and we have conducted analysis of velocity and acceleration for 4 bar mechanism for both 4 bar mechanism as well as for slider crank mechanism, and also we have solved numerical problems on it. And later we took Fredrickson's method to determine velocity and acceleration of 4 bar mechanism, and we have solved expressions for angular displacement, angular velocity and angular acceleration for 4 bar mechanism. In today's lecture, continuing further by recalling the formulas what we have derived in our previous 2 lectures, moving ahead I will be discussing a numerical problem on 4 bar mechanism, which I will solve using Fredrickson's method. The problem number 3 of our discussion on velocity and acceleration analysis of mechanisms, which is based on Fredrickson's approach, states that ABCD is a 4 bar mechanism with link AD fixed. The lengths of the links are AB is equal to 300 mm, BC is equal to 360 mm. CD is equal to 360 mm and AD is equal to 600 mm. The crank AB has an angular velocity of 10 radians per second and the angular acceleration of 30 radians per second square, both anti-clockwise. Find the angular displacement, velocities and accelerations of the link BC and CD for a crank angle of 30 degrees. If you carefully observe, he has given a 4 bar mechanism and all the link lengths are known to us, and he has also specified the input crank angle as well as the angular velocity and angular acceleration of crank. So, using which I should compute the angular velocity and angular acceleration as well as the angular displacement of both coupler as well as rocker. Let us solve this problem. So, moving ahead, so if I solve the 4 bar mechanism, if I consider for the given problem, so if I list out the data for the given problem, we have a 4 bar mechanism ABCD. ABCD is a 4 bar mechanism. He has given the length AB is 300, BC is 360, CD is 360 and AD is 600, that is 300 mm, BC is 360 mm, CD is also 360 mm and he has specified the fixed link AD or DA as 600 mm. Apart from that, he has specified the crank angle, that is 30 degrees, that is theta. Theta is specified as 30 degrees. And he has given the values of omega 1 and alpha 1, that is omega 1 and alpha 1, that is crank angular velocity and angular acceleration. Angular velocity is 10 radians per second, 10 radians per second, and an angular acceleration is also given as 30 radians per second square. 30 radians per second square. So, this is the given problem for us, and he is asking us to calculate the angular displacement, angular velocity and angular acceleration of both coupler as well as rocker. So, if I draw the sketch, rough sketch to analyze the given problem, we have the 4 bar mechanism like this. So, for the 4 bar mechanism, he has given the values of omega 2 and alpha 2, sorry, we are using omega 1 here, this is omega 1 comma alpha 1, keep that in mind. So, this itself is link 1 for us in Fredrickson's approach. This is A, B, C,
and D are the link lengths. We have the 4 bar chain as AB, C and D. So this is fixed link. So we know the values of A, BC is small b, CD is small c and DA is small d. And the vectors are like this. This is the vector what we have considered, and he has specified the value of theta also. Theta is given as 30 degrees. And I want to calculate what is the value of this beta. Beta is what he is asking, and also he is asking what is the value of phi. So I should calculate beta as well as phi, and also what is the value of omega 2 alpha 2, omega 3 alpha 3. So that is from Fredenstein's method. We have from Fredenstein's method, if I consider, we know that omega 1 comma alpha 1 are with reference to crank, that is AB, which is link 1 for us, and omega 2 and alpha 2 are with reference to coupler, that is for link BC, which we call it as link 2, and omega 3 and alpha 3 are with reference to rocker or output link CD, that is link 3, and finally we have the fixed link, that is AD, which can be called as link 4. For this we have derived the suitable expressions to calculate omega 2 alpha 2, omega 3 alpha 3, and also angle made by coupler, that is beta. Angle made by rocker is phi, and angle made by crank is theta. So in which he has given all the values for crank, and he is asking to calculate the values of both coupler and rocker. Apart from this, he has given the link lengths. All the link lengths are known for us. A, B, C, D is also specified. So I want to calculate beta omega 2 alpha 2, phi omega 3 alpha 3. So to do that, I should recall the Fredenstein's equation what we have derived. That is, I want all the expressions what we have done in our previous two lectures. So if I recall what I have done in Fredenstein's method of analytical approach to determine velocity and acceleration of 4 bar chain. So we have considered the 4 bar chain and we have calculated the Fredenstein's equation for angular displacement, which is this equation. In this equation we should know the value of k1, k2 and k3. So note down this k1, k2 and k3. So k1, k2, k3 is required to determine the value of phi and beta. So I note down this k1, k2, k3, and later I will take the equation of phi, that is tan phi. Phi is equal to 2 times tan inverse of minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a, where a, b, c is given by this equation. So I will take this equation also into account. So I note down k1, k2, k3, a, b and c. So using which I will calculate the value of phi. So careful observation is that I will get two angular positions of the output link, that is two angular displacements. If I take plus, I will get one answer. If I take minus, I will get another answer. So similarly for beta also, I will get two answers, where E, D and F are listed here, for which K4 and K5 is also required, which we have clearly discussed in our lecture 5 itself. Next, moving for lecture 6, we have discussed the angular acceleration equations. and angular velocity equation. Angular velocity equation for coupler and rocker, omega 2 and omega 3 are calculated. So this is the equation for omega 3 and this is the equation for omega 2. That is angular velocity of coupler, angular velocity of rocker. This also I will note down. And finally, we have calculated the angular acceleration equations, that is alpha 2 and alpha 3. I will note down these two also. So once I know all these formulas, I can solve the given problem for us using Fredenstein's method. So whenever you are solving problems on Fredenstein's method, first you calculate the constants k1, k2, k3, k4 and k5. So recalling which, I can write displacement comma velocity and acceleration analysis results. We have first I should note down the constants k1, k2, k3, k4 and k5. The first constants what we had in Fredenstein equation is k1, k2 and k3. So using which we have calculated the values of a, b and c. So if you use this, you are going to get the value of angular displacement of coupler. That is, sorry, angular displacement of rocker, that is the output link, phi can be obtained using this. So if you use this, you can find the value of phi. Use this and I can find the value of phi. So similarly, if I recall k4 and k5 what I computed, and if I recall the equations of d, e and f, I can calculate the value of beta, right? So just now I have shown the expressions for these terms. So let me recall and write these values and calculate what, how much answer I am going to get. First, if I go for k1, k1 is given by d by a. So it is given the values of d. D is 600 and A is 300, you will get the value as 2. Next, K2 is given by D by C. It is given the value of D as 600, value of C is 360, calculate the value. Coming for K3, we know that the formula for K3 is a square minus b square plus c square divided by 2ac. You know all the values, substitute. The value of a is given to us, which is 300, value of b is 360, value of C is 360 and value of D is 600. Whole thing is divided by 2 times value of A is 300, that is dimension of crank. Coming for C, C is output link, that is rocker. Rocker length is 360 mm, whereas the transmission link coupler length is also same, it is 360 mm. So if we solve this, I am going to get the value as K2 is turning out to be 5 by 3 and K3 will be 25 by 12. So this is what you are going to get for this problem. So I have calculated K1, K2, K3. So now moving for calculation of K4 and K5. So if I go for K4, the formula for K4 is D by B. We know the value of D given as 600 mm. B is nothing but dimension of transmission link, that is coupler. Coupler length is 360 mm. So if I substitute and solve, I will get the same answer as 5/3. Next, coming for the value of constant K phi. K phi equation is C square minus A square minus B square minus D square. C square minus A square minus B square minus D square, whole of this should be divided by 2AB. So substitute all the values. C is the dimension of output link which is given for us, which is 360 mm. A is dimension of input link crank, which is 300 mm. B is nothing but the value of coupler, which is 360 mm, coupler link dimension, and D is fixed link, which is 600 mm. Whole of this is divided by 2 times A is 300 and B is 360. So if I substitute all these values in the calculator and if I compute, I will get the answer as minus 25/12. Minus 25/12 is the answer for K5. So we have calculated K1, K2, K3, K4 and K5. So if I know K1, K2, K3, I can find A, B, C, hence I can find the value of phi. If I know K4 and K5, I can find D, E, F, hence I can find the value of beta. So we have calculated all the constants K1 to K5. Next, I can find A, B, C, D, E, F. So find the value of A. First, if I want to find the value of A, so formula for A is given by 1 minus K2 cos theta plus K3 minus K1. So therefore, the value of A will become 1 minus 5/3 into cos of 30 degrees plus K3. K3 is 25/12 minus K1. K1 is 2. So hence, I will get the value of A as, if I solve this in calculator, I will get the answer for A as minus 0.494. Minus 0.494. Minus 0.494. Similarly, if I recall the equation of B, B is minus 2 sin theta, which is nothing but minus 2 into sin of 30 degree, which is turning out to be minus 1. Next, coming for the value of C. Formula for C is also known for us, which we have calculated. It is K1 plus K3 minus 1 plus K2 into cos theta. So substitute all the values. K1 is 2, K3 is 25/12 minus 1 plus the value of K2 is computed as 5/3 into cos of theta is input crank angle, which is given for us, that is 30 degrees. If I substitute these values into calculator and calculate, I will get the value of C, which is turning out to be 1.774. So you can solve using calculator. So we got the values of A, B and C. Now find the value of DEF. So if I find the value of D, E and F, so the formula for D is given by K4 plus 1, 1 plus K4 cos theta plus K3 minus K1 plus K5 minus K1. Let me substitute the values and calculate here itself. If I substitute the values and calculate, I will get 1 plus the value of K4 is calculated as 5 by 3. So therefore, K4 is calculated as 5 by 3 into cos of 30 degrees plus K5. So formula for K5 is 25 minus 25 by 12. K5 is minus 25 by 12 minus K1. K1 is calculated as 2. So hence, if I solve, I will get the value of D as, the value of D is turning out to be minus 1.774. You can check the value. If you put it in calculator and calculate, you will get the answer as minus 1.774. Now calculate the value of E. The formula for E is specified as minus 2 sin theta. So if I substitute the values, it is minus 2 sin 30 degrees. Hence I will get the answer as minus 1. Coming for F, the formula for F is derived and it is K4 minus 1 times cos theta plus K5 plus K1. If you substitute all the values, we know the value of K4 5 by 3, theta is 30 degrees, K5 is minus 25 by 12, K1 is 2. If I substitute and solve, I will get the value of F as 0.494. It is 0.494. So we have calculated the values of K1, K2, K3, K4, K5 and also we have calculated A, B, C, D, E and F. So now if you observe, for beta and phi we have two values. So if I recall the equation of beta, we have two values. So beta is given by the formula tan 2 times tan inverse of minus E plus or minus square root of E square minus 4df divided by 2d. So this is what we have. So therefore I can find the two values of beta. Beta is equal to 2 times tan inverse of, we know the value of E and F, E is minus 1, so it will become plus 1 plus root of 1 plus 4 into df 1.774 4 into 1.774 into 0.494 divided by 2 into minus 1.774. This is one equation, and another equation will be 2 times tan inverse of 1 minus root of 1 plus 4 into 1.774 into 0.494 whole divided by 2 times minus 1.774. If I substitute all the values and calculate, I will get the answers as the two values of beta are minus 82.7 and another answer is turning out to be 35.12. 35.12. The two answers are minus 82.7 degrees and 35.1 degrees. Next, similarly, I can find two values of phi. So we know that phi is equal to 2 times tan inverse of minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. So now if I substitute the values of a, b, c, that is phi 1 will become 2 times tan inverse of, find the value of, recall the values of b, b is minus 1, a is minus 0.494, c is plus 1.774. So substitute these values. So b is minus 1, minus of minus is plus 1, plus square root of b square will become plus 1, plus 4 into 0.494 into 1.77 divided by 2 into 0.494. The value of a is minus 2 into minus 0.494. So solve this, you will get the value of phi 1. Similarly, phi 2 will become 2 times tan inverse of 1 minus root of 1 plus 4 into 0.494 into 1.77 divided by 2 times minus 0.494. If you solve, you will get the two values of output link, angular displacement of output link, which are turning out to be minus 145, that is minus 144.9 degrees, and another answer is turning out to be 97.3. So if you substitute these values in calculator and compute, you will get the two answers for angular positions of output link, that is for rocker. So we have calculated the first question, what he has asked, find the angular displacements of coupler and rocker. The angular displacements of coupler are minus 82.7 degree and 35 degree respectively, and the angles of two angles of output link, that is for rocker, is minus 144.9 and 97.3 degrees. For one input angle 30 degree, we have two possible angles of both coupler as well as rocker. So this completes the calculation of angular displacement. Now moving ahead for calculating angular velocity. So moving for calculation of angular velocity, so recalling the expression for angular velocity, we have omega 2 is given by minus b, it is minus a into sine of phi minus theta divided by d into sine of phi minus beta into omega 1. So again we will get the two answers, omega 2 for two values of phi and beta, that is A is known for us link length of input link, that is 300 mm into sine of, first let me take the plus values of phi. So plus value of phi is, when I use plus sign I got minus 144.9, that is minus 144.9 minus theta is 30 degrees given, divided by the value of B is 360 into sine of angle phi is minus 144.9 minus beta. So beta for positive value is minus 82.7. So minus of minus will become plus 82.7 into omega 1. So omega 1 is given in the data for us. The value of omega 1 for this problem is 10 radians per second. So hence multiply this with 10 radians per second. So you will get the value of angular velocity of coupler. So omega 2 will become minus 0.84 minus 0.84 radians per second. So similarly I can compute the second value of omega 2, that is minus 300 sine of, use the second angles of beta and phi, second angle of phi is 97.3, that is 97.3 minus theta is 30 degrees divided by 360 into sine of, second angle is 97.3, the second angle of beta is 35 degrees minus 35, so into 10. So if I solve I will get the answer as minus 8.69 radians per second. So this is what we have for omega 2. So we got two values of angular velocities. Negative sign indicates that it is rotating in clockwise direction. If I get positive answer then it states that it is rotating in counterclockwise direction. If you remember we have used the sign convention as for positive notations the links are rotating in clockwise direction, for negative the links are rotating in counterclockwise direction. Next, moving for omega 3. So if I recall the expression what I have derived for omega 3, so we have derived the expression for omega 3 as minus A sine of beta minus theta divided by C times sine of phi minus beta into omega 1. When derived we took it as positive because we take the difference as beta minus phi. If you want it to be positive then you should write it as sine of beta minus phi. So now let us substitute and solve the two values of omega 3. So the two values of omega 3 will become minus, the input link length is known which is 300 into sine of, the first values of beta are already calculated which is minus 82.7 minus theta is 30 degrees given divided by the value of C is 360 mm, that is link length of output link, that is link length of rocker, the value of phi is minus 144, just now we have calculated 144.9 minus the value of beta is minus 82, minus of minus will become plus 82.7. This is multiplied by omega 1 is 10 radians per second. So if I solve, I will get the answer as -8.69. -8.69 radians per second. So similarly for omega, second values of omega 3, let me use second angles of beta and phi. So 300 into sine of, we have the second angle of beta as 35 degrees, 35.12 minus 30 divided by 360 into sine of the second angles of phi. Phi is 97 and we have minus beta, beta is 35.12 plus 35.12. So minus into plus is minus, minus 35.12 into omega 1 is 10 radians per second. So if I solve, I will get the value as -0.84 unit is radians per second. So this completes the answers for angular velocity of coupler and angular velocity of rocker. Moving ahead, the final question what he has asked is angular acceleration. To find angular acceleration. So if I recall, angular acceleration of coupler alpha 2, equation of alpha 2, if I recall, I will get the equation of alpha 2 as alpha 2 is equal to minus A alpha 1 sine of alpha 1 into sine of phi minus theta plus A omega 1 square cos of phi minus theta plus B omega 2 square cos of phi plus phi minus beta, phi minus beta minus C omega 3 square, whole of this should be divided by B sine of phi minus beta. So this is the expression what we have derived for alpha 2, angular acceleration. So if you want, if I recall, so we have derived the values of angular acceleration also for in our previous lectures. So this is what I recalled, though this is what we have derived in our previous lecture. I recalled this equation to solve this problem. So just now I recalled that expression what I have derived in our previous lecture. So just I have rewritten that expression here once again. So now you know all the values, substitute all the values, and if you calculate for first values of beta phi omega 2 and omega 3, you will get the value of alpha 2 as 181.43 radians per second square, radians per second square. For second values, if I use second values of beta phi omega 2 and omega 3, I will get the value of alpha 2 as alpha 2 will become 101.5 radians per second square. So this is what you are going to get. Now moving for the angular acceleration of output link alpha 3. So if I recall the expression what I derived for alpha 3, So we have derived the equation for alpha 3 in our previous lecture itself. That is, so this is the expression we have derived in our previous lecture, alpha 3. Let me recall this equation once again and substitute the values what we have for the given problem. That is, if I substitute the values of alpha 3 to the equation what we have derived, that is minus a alpha 1 sin of beta minus theta plus a omega 1 square cos of beta minus theta plus b omega 2 square minus c omega 3 square cos of phi minus beta, whole of this should be divided by c sin phi minus beta. So substitute all the values, because we know all the values in this equation. If I used first values of beta, phi, omega 2 and omega 3, I will get the value of alpha 3 as 101.52 radians per second square. If I use the second values of beta, phi, omega 2 and omega 3, I will get the value of alpha 3 as 181.43 radians per second square. So this is the complete solution for the given problem. So whenever you want to address the problems on Feuerstein's method, you should always compute the constants k1 to k5 first. That is what I have done. I pictorially represented the given problem and I calculated the values of k1, k2, k3, k4, k5. If you calculate k1 to k5, using k1 to k3, I can calculate the values of abc, which in turn gives us the values of angular displacement of phi. Similarly, if I know the values of k4, k5, I can calculate def, using which I can calculate the angular displacement of the coupler, that is beta angle. So you can see here I calculated k1, k2, k3, k4 and k5, using which I can calculate the values of a, b, c, d, e and f. So if you calculate a, b, c, d, e and f, we can calculate the values of beta. So for angular positions of coupler as well as angular positions of rocker, you should get two answers, because in the equation itself we have plus or minus. If I use plus, I will get one answer. If I use minus, I will get another answer. So accordingly, I will get the two positions for output link also. For plus, I will get one answer. For minus, I will get another answer. So this I am considering it as first set of values. This I am taking as second set of values. So use first set of values in calculation of angular velocity of coupler, you will get one answer. Second set, you will get another answer. Similarly, angular velocity of output link for rocker, you will get two answers. So repeat the same procedure for calculation of angular acceleration. For first values you will get one answer, for second values you will get another answer. So thereby we have calculated the angular positions of coupler as well as rocker. So this is the brief outline of the given problem wherein which I discussed. We know these values. Apart from all the link lengths, he has asked us to calculate these values, that is angular positions of coupler as well as rocker. All these have two sets of answers. So that is what we have done. So the final answer for this problem regarding the accelerations are also calculated, and the angular acceleration of output link from the first set, it is 101.52 radians per second square. From the second set, it is 181.43 radians per second square. So this completes the given problem. So this is how you should approach a numerical problems whenever asked on Feuerstein's method. You can also try to solve the same problem using Raven's approach, which we have discussed in our lecture 1 to lecture 4,
you can use that method also and cross verify the answers what we have got. Of course, the formulas should be remembered, otherwise we cannot solve the problem. So kindly look into the formulas. In our next lecture, I will take up Feuerstein's approach to conduct velocity and acceleration analysis of slider crank mechanism. That's all from today's lecture. Thank you all.